Hello everyone, this is Nitpicking Nerd and I want to review the new episode of The Orville. Season 2 just started and expectations were pretty high after the excellent first season. And usually the first and last episodes of a season are some of the best episodes because they always want to hook the fans to the show. So I was kind of surprised that nothing big happened in this whole episode, the first episode of season 2. So it was a bit disappointing for a season premiere because it felt like just a filler episode which you would usually find in the middle of a season. Very little things actually happened except character interactions, and in Star Trek these kinds of scenes were usually just the B-plot of an episode, and there was always an A-plot which was always more interesting and having to do with something happening outside the ship as well. Although I do think once in a while there were entire episodes filled with B-plots, and that was what was called the bottle episodes because it all took place only on the ship. And I can think of a few examples of episodes like that in TNG, including a few episodes that I think inspired this one, like the episode in which Worf had to go through some ceremony, getting hit by paint sticks, going through some nipple torture ritual as his friends had to watch. And that really reminds me of what they did with Bortus in this episode, which I did find funny. Not hilarious, but I did find it funny. And definitely better than the Worf scene, which I'm not even sure if they were trying to be comedic with that or if it was unintentionally funny. But seeing aliens do weird things and seeing the human characters react to that is always fun to see. And in this case, Bortus has to go through a ceremony to take a leak, which his kind is only doing once a year, which was mentioned in the very first episode of The Orville, so I love the fact that they always tie into all those little remarks, which originally I thought were just meant as a quick joke, but they always later expand on all those little details, so I do appreciate that attention to detail. And so Bortus was definitely inspired by Worf in TNG, and at the same time it doesn't feel as if they're just stealing the idea, because it's different enough that it feels fresh and original, and also funnier, without feeling like it's mocking the original show that inspired it. And so I'm mostly fine with what they're doing. And I was also reminded of the TNG episode Lessons in season 6, in which Picard fell in love with a crew member and then had to send her on a dangerous mission where she almost died, and then he realized he can't be with her and stay a captain because he'd be unable to make such choices again. So that's really similar to the scene in which Kelly explains why she can't be in a relationship with her captain, and she basically described to him exactly the kind of scenario that we saw in that TNG episode, Lessons. So I was a little bit annoyed at that, because wouldn't it be more interesting to actually see a scenario like that play out instead of just hearing her talk about it theoretically? So use the old rule, show, don't tell. If you want it to be a good series, you have to actually show us those things and not just talk about them in the episode while everybody sits at the table, so it's more boring this way. So I definitely feel that the influence of TNG inspiring the show, also all the stuff with Isaac, obviously very similar to Data, only a bit more outrageous in a good way. I just wish again that he'd actually do something in this episode instead of just talking. And it definitely felt like a collection of B-plots that should have been spread over multiple episodes just to fill in little gaps in episodes with bigger stories, and then it would be fine, but seeing all of it together in one episode did feel kind of boring and meaningless, even though all the shows had episodes like that once in a while, but I wouldn't expect that in the beginning of a season, which we were waiting months to get to. And as for the humor, I did find a lot of funny things in this episode, like Ed taking a shuttle to sneak into the window of his ex to see who she's dating. That was funny. And by the way, her new boyfriend is a school teacher on the ship, and he seemed super nice. And as I was watching that, I kind of suddenly remembered how nice everyone were on the Enterprise D to an almost unrealistic level, which is something Gene Roddenberry always insisted to show, that humanity became perfect in the future and there are no more problems. Which was a very nice vision, but not really realistic, and also a problem on a TV show, because how can you have drama with characters like that who are all too perfect? And so I was just thinking about how all the characters on the Orville are not like that, and rather they are like real people of today. And I was kind of thinking to myself, is that a good thing or a bad thing? And then this teacher character kind of started behaving like those early TNG humans who were all perfect, and then Kelly called him out for it and said, do you always have to be so evolved? And she said that she feels completely disconnected from him because he has like a high road attitude. So I find that very funny, because it almost sounded like a criticism of those early TNG attitude. Because early on in that show they were always showing that the crew are all evolved humans who did seem kind of snobbish. always telling other aliens that they're still primitive compared to them, and that they're the way that humans used to be in ancient times, and now they're all evolved humans, and always they say things like, that nonsense is centuries behind us, or we no longer enslave animals for food purposes, or, oh look, they still use money, how primitive. All kinds of comments like that in a snobbish way, which did seem kind of unrealistic. And of course, later on in that series, when they kind of dropped all those things, it made them look even more hypocritical, even more annoying if you look back at those early seasons, because it seemed like they had this annoying attitude in which they think they're better than everybody else, which I think is one of the reasons that people hate the social justice warriors, which is often not because of the actual messages they're trying to push, but the way they act as if they are superior and snobbish and preachy to others. So you have the same kind of feeling when you watch the early TNG. And so seeing Kelly calling out this new character for being that way was kind of funny. So as I said, this entire episode was kind of a collection of B-plots, with Bortus needing to pee being the beginning and end of the episode, obviously inspired by the Worf nipple torture ceremony in season 2, which I think was also a bottle episode made up of only B-plots. There was another plot about Riker being depressed because he had daddy issues, and so he dressed up like a Power Ranger to beat up his dad, and then they became friends. And Worf was grumpy until he went through that torture ceremony, and then he was happy again. And I wish they do more with Bortus in this Orville episode, because there was too little of his actual story except the beginning and end. And I'd actually be interesting to learn about his culture and history and hear about how that ritual evolved. And also, they never actually showed him peeing, which was disappointing, because I half expected to see something epic that was accumulating for a whole year, but we didn't actually see anything in the end, so that was disappointing. I guess they didn't want to go too far with the toilet humor, but I think it would have been forgivable in this case, because, you know, it's an alien, so I expect to see weird stuff, including all kinds of bodily humor. That's part of what makes aliens funny, like they did in the first episode with the blue guy squirting from his forehead, so that was funny, so I'd be fine with stuff like that. And there was another B-plot about the Doctor's teenage son being friends with another kid who is a bad influence, and that really reminded me of the Jake and Nog B-plots in the early seasons of Deep Space Nine, which were some of my least favorite parts of that show. And just a quick note, it's funny how as Deep Space Nine progressed, it was actually Nog who became a Starfleet officer, even though he was the problematic child in the beginning, he was the bad influence. And Jake was the son of a Starfleet captain, so you would have expected him to be the officer later, and yet it was actually Nog who became a Starfleet officer. And Deep Space Nine became a much better show as it progressed, and all his characters evolved greatly, but the first two seasons of that show were pretty bad, and all the Nog and Jake stories were kind of boring, so this part of the Orville episode reminded me of that, not in a good way. TNG also had a lot of episodes about kids on the ship, which also didn't really work most of the time, and I'm fine with stuff like that being in the background of an episode or even as filler scenes in an episode, but don't make it the main plot of an entire episode, please. Unless you have a really good story for them, which this wasn't. And so I'm a bit concerned for the future of the Orville after this episode, because my biggest fear is that maybe they crammed all the best ideas they had into the first season and will not have as many new good ideas left. And hopefully that's not the case, and we'll be getting some good and original stories and not just recycled filler stuff. So I really hope that this episode is not an indication of things to come. In terms of the humor, I did find a lot of moments funny, like seeing the guys practice how to get dates on the holodeck, sort of the simulator. Also, we got to see some brand new aliens on the ship, which is always fun. And we got to see a bunch of new sets and the new parts of the ship that we didn't see before, so it's nice that they are expanding their production value in that regard. There was one visual special effects goof that I noticed and found pretty annoying when they showed the ship in space. You see this halo around the engines, and you could clearly see that it's contained inside the square. And I took a snapshot of it, I don't know if you can see it here on YouTube, but I think if I increase the brightness you would be able to see it, because I clearly saw the lines of a square containing the special effect they used, so I guess they forgot to blur out the edges. And I found this very annoying because it took me out of the moment, it reminded me that this is not a real ship, it's just a special effect. So that destroys my suspension of disbelief, it damages my escapism. So this was some sloppy work.
Some damn sloppy work!
So hopefully this is just a one-time glitch and won't happen again. And as I said many times before, I love the visual style of the show, it's all pleasant to look at. And that is very important to experience good escapism, you have to see a place that you want to be in. So that's all I have to say about this episode. It was a bit weak, but hopefully it's not an indication of things to come, and I hope it will be at least as good as season 1 was. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and I will see you all next time.